I mean, can you imagine somebody having $32 million? $32 million. And this person has nothing? And you can sleep? You can still go to the movies about, I mean, and then these are the type of people that get humanitarian awards. Millionaires. How can they be humanitarians by the fact that they're millionaires and there's so many poor people shows how unhumane they are. I think there's a way to pay these people. I think there is a way. It just takes to be revolutionary, and it takes to do something out of the ordinary.
Now, one of the answers, it seems to me, is a guaranteed annual income, a guaranteed minimum income for all people and for all families of our country.
And it need to be before we all die, and then you say, oh, I made a mistake. We should have gave them some money. We really should have helped these folks. It's going to be too late. You know what I'm saying? And then that's when you got to pay your own karma. And that's when God make you punish, when God punishes you. Because I feel like, you know, it's too much money here. It need to be before we all die, and then you say, oh, I made a mistake. We should have gave them some money. We really should have helped these folks. It's going to be too late. It's going to be too late.
Right now, I'm not excited about the world we're leaving to our kids. I mean, our life expectancy has declined for the last 3 years due to a surge in drug overdoses and suicides. 78% of Americans are living paycheck to paycheck. 57% say they can't afford an unexpected $500 bill. And so people are looking around and saying, wait a minute, if GDP is at a record high, why do things feel so lousy?
How can you say an economy is healthy when our people are dying?
If you say, oh, someone else will take care of this, that almost never works. So I decided I could make a contribution.
So I came to Washington, D.C., and I said, what are we going to do? This official said to me, Andrew, you're in the wrong town. No one in this town is going to do anything about the problems that you described, because this town is a town of followers, not leaders. And the only way for us to do something about it is if you bring a wave crashing down on our heads. I looked at that and I thought, these words.
Challenge fucking accepted.
We talk about it like Donald Trump is the cause of all of our problems. He is not. He is a symptom. He is a manifestation. We are going through the greatest economic transformation in our country's history.
I'm the son of immigrants myself. And if you go to a factory here in Michigan, you will not find wall-to-wall immigrants. You will find wall-to-wall robots and machines. Immigrants are being scapegoated for issues they have nothing to do with in our economy.
And what we did to the manufacturing jobs, we will now do to the retail jobs, the call center jobs, the fast food jobs, the truck driving jobs, and on through the economy.
Raise your hand in the crowd if you've seen stores closing where you live. It is not just you. Amazon is closing 30% of America's stores and malls and paying zero in taxes.
In a country that is tearing itself apart with people turning on each other, this is the mindset of scarcity that is sweeping our country. We have to make big choices right now as a country. We have to start evolving and advancing in terms of the way we see our economy and our role within it. What we have to do is we have to focus on fixing the system that is distorting and dehumanizing. I'm running for president because I'm an American and I'm a parent, and I can see the country we will leave to our children, and it is not something that I'm willing to accept.
The only thing I worry about is that some total unknown that nobody ever heard of.
That's the
when
man.
The land flows, what did I see? A
that's
bad
the
motherfucker
math.
Standing next to
that's
me
the math.
With his eyes closed.
That's the math.
Do the math, motherfucker.